Construction crews paved the way for Kansas City's professional tennis team. Today, the city and Explorers announced the team will practice and compete at a new tennis court at Barney Alice Plaza, located between 12th and 13th Streets.
Mark Kuhn of Charles City has never been to the Wimbledon Tennis Championships, but he's brought a little slice of the All-England Lawn Tennis and Croquet Club to Eastern Iowa.
I had no idea it was going to end up like this.
For players who come here, it's like the tennis version of Field of Dreams. They fall in love with the place.
Paralympic tennis gold medalist and Wichita native Nick Taylor. Taylor, a quadriplegic and member of Team USA for the World Cup, has competed all over the world and won a gold medal in wheelchair tennis doubles at the 2004 Athens Paralympic Games. Today he was in the capital city to show off his skills and give youngsters some advice in the world of tennis.
Hook a couple of them and they'll come back for more.
You know, the state of tennis is actually very positive. We see all of our draws increasing. We see a lot more adults taking it up even later in life. And we've definitely seen an uptick in our participation across the country.
This is a great way to work on your cardio workout, get your cardiovascular system nice and strong. And the idea is try to get your heart rate up to 80 to 85% of the time for about 30 to 40 minutes. And this is the best workout you can get.
This is tennis like you've never seen it before. This workout does involve a racket and ball, but it also includes a lot of twists and turns and, well, obstacles to overcome.
I love playing the game.
They hope to get to Wimbledon one day. Hundreds of area kids are in town for a tennis tournament. It is the Missouri Valley section of the U.S. Tennis Association.
27 News reporter Haley Harrison finds out what this event means for Topeka's underprivileged youth.
Use tennis as possibly just a springboard to get into college and just do, you know, bigger and better things with their lives.
Our goal is more become a doctor, become a lawyer, become a professional, and serve your community.
Dozens of athletes got some practice time on the courts in Forest Park at the first annual Special Olympics Tennis Clinic. The Washington University men's and women's tennis coaches and players helped put on the clinic.
The 10th annual tennis block party from Davenport Central. Boys and girls met at the net for games and skill drills. Former mayor of New York David Dinkins, along with the United States Tennis Association, hosted the traveling camp, hopes of bringing serves and forehands to the forefront for young athletes.
It's important to so kids can explore different kinds of sports.
The Wimbledon Championships begin next week, and while all eyes will be on the big names, there's one local young lady who is making her first appearance.
16-year-old Chloe Jones is serious about her tennis game.
Be careful with your legs.
But you'll have to forgive Chloe for being a little giddy about what's coming next in her career. Later this month, she will travel with the USTA team to play in the Wimbledon Junior event.
Oh, I love Wimbledon. It's like the Grand Slam of the year.
You can get an entry-level racket for not much money and a can of balls. You can buy them at discount for about $2. And playing on public courts is free.
The best Division II college tennis teams are in town for the national championship tournament. Competition is taking place at the Homestead Country Club as well as the Plaza Tennis Courts.
More important, though, is that local grassroots teaching pro, coach, parent.
If you see these kids, I love tennis!
Yes! I love playing the game.